Hi there, folks. All right, so many of you probably have heard this already. We do have an El Nino that has developed in the Pacific Ocean. And the question tonight, something that people have been asking about, is could the El Nino that develops now have an effect on the coming winter? Well, it certainly could. In fact, it oftentimes does have a pretty big impact on the United States. This is a look at a graphic here. It's called the Oceanic Nino Index. And what do we notice here? Well, the higher up we go in numbers right here, the more likely that you have an El Nino developing, and certainly the stronger the El Nino is. So these are our index numbers, and you can see the strongest El Ninos on the map right here, a little bit further up on this graphic. So in 1957 and 58, we had a pretty strong El Nino, and you can see the index number was between about 1.5 and 2. So that's a strong El Nino. We had another one in 1965 and 1966, another one there in 1972 and 1973. So all the strongest El Ninos going back to 1950, including the strongest El Nino we ever saw in 1997 and 1998, were able to use this index system. So what we did was we took the 10 strongest El Ninos since 1950 and compared them to what our winter temperatures looked like that winter. So here's our strongest El Ninos, and then you can see the more normal El Ninos of that 10 here in the orange shading going all the way to 2002 and 2009, 2010. So during these El Nino years, you see a lot of blue on the map. Our temperatures during the winter were 3.6 degrees below average in 1963 and 1964 during that El Nino. And you can see a lot of blue on this map, below average temperatures during these winters. But we also had above average temperatures. In fact, during the 91-92 El Nino event, the warmest winter in this area that we ever saw. So it can still be warmer than average even during these strong El Nino events, and during the strongest El Nino event we ever had on record. 2 degrees above average during that winter in this area. And they are forecasting a pretty strong, that's what we think right now, pretty strong El Nino to occur, possibly even beating out the 97-98 El Nino in terms of strength. So we can't guarantee colder than average temperatures during an El Nino year, even though we do generally see colder than average temperatures during most El Nino years, just not all of them. So as we take a look right here, this is from NOAA and NOAA's winter prediction. All right, this came out earlier in the summer, and this is for December, January, and February. You can see they are forecasting a higher than normal likelihood of below average temperatures in the south and in the southeast, including Arkansas, with about equal chances. That's what the EC is about, equal chances of below and above average precipitation. So a little bit harder to say on precipitation in this part of the country with El Nino, but it always, always, always is very wet in Southern California during especially strong El Nino events. So can we say again definitively that it will be a colder or warmer than average winter? No, but we can say our chances are a little bit higher for a colder than average winter with most El Nino events in this part of the country. So that's kind of what we're talking about tonight. If you have any other questions, of course, you can join us for the live wire tonight at 8 p.m. And of course, you can send questions to me at Facebook. You can send those questions to me on Twitter and on my email address as well.